the labour disputes, which seem to be that much worse down Liverpool way, and this week there's trouble in the docks and at Ford's plant at Halewood on the Mersey. This week too, the rumour started that Leyland might close their strike-hit factory at Speke, even though it's one of their most modern plants. Leyland's not an exception. In the past few years, a number of big companies have either moved away from Merseyside or cancelled plans to set up there. John Withington is with our outside broadcast cameras in Liverpool's Labour Club, but first, Angela Lambert sets the scene for us tonight.
Has your husband ever been out on strike?
Yeah.
How do you manage when he's on strike?
You have to do your savings, what you've got, you know.
Do you think it's harder for the wives than it is for the men?
I think they both find it difficult, don't they? One suffers with the housekeeping, the other with the pocket money.
Do you think Liverpool workers are lazier than people?
They are damn lazy. Yeah. Damn lazy.
What makes you say that?
Well, strikes, brother. What's 1 minute to stay in their house, aren't they?
Has your husband ever been out on strike?
Yes, and I was discussing it with him.
Has your husband ever been out on strike?
No, he's out of work. He's been out for 2 years. He can't get a job, but he wants one.
He wants
but
work.
He's just like starting to go lazy with not having a job.
Why do you think Liverpool men are lazier than...
It's not lazy, it's greedy, I think, now.
Yeah, you think the men are greedy?
I think the men are greedy.
In what way?
Well, we've got to manage on. They don't give you any extra. You've got to manage.
This is Liverpool, and the feelings expressed by those wives are not uncommon here. Unemployment at 11.5% is almost twice as high on Merseyside as the average for the rest of the country. That means, in cold figures, over 87,000 people out of work. Jobs have fallen by 100,000 since 1966. The city and its people bear the scars of economic and personal depression. But why should this area in the northwest have such high unemployment? Is there, as some have suggested, a Liverpool disease that makes firms unwilling to invest in new factories and jobs on Merseyside? Certainly, the area has a reputation for militancy, gained when Liverpool was the country's second greatest port and the unions ruled supreme in the docks. That militancy spread to other unions. Strikes were frequent, and Liverpool workers acquired a reputation for laziness that they haven't been able to lose. In times of economic recession, plant on Merseyside is the first to be cut back. Many major companies have moved out of Liverpool in the last few years, among them Courtauld's, Plessy and Thorne.
These men have been out on unofficial strike for the past 10 weeks, and British Leyland's car factory here at Speke hasn't had a TR7 off the production line since last September. So what issue can be so important that these men are prepared to put their jobs at risk and possibly the whole future of this factory at stake? The men say that the 1972 agreement, which laid down disputes procedure, was unilaterally broken by the management, and that their new production levels of about 18 cars an hour are too high to be reached with current manning levels. But the management says that the new production level is necessary if this factory is to stay viable. And they say that lengthy negotiations with the shop stewards had failed to produce an agreement, and so they were forced to impose the new production level.